Hi, class. Doop, 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 doop. Hey, let's gonna start the class, all right? Today, we are going to start the unit product of the month of December. This is part one, okay? Remember que para nuestro month of December, we are going to make, or we are gonna give, an opinion, daremos una opinión, ¿ok? Para eso, primero vamos a write, alright, vamos a escribirla. Ya hemos escrito algunas opinions, alright, hemos visto, leído, visto expresiones para utilizar. Entonces hoy comenzamos a trabajar en nuestro unit product, ¿ok? So, last session, you made a chart with your ideas to write your opinion, okay? La sesión pasada, you made a chart, yes, hicimos un chart, un cuadrito, with ideas to write your opinion, yes? Escribimos ideas sobre what we think about the schools being closed because of the pandemic, okay? So, in this chart, you wrote one idea here, and another idea here, and then a reason, and then your conclusion, right? Escribimos una idea aquí, and otra idea acá, and a reason here, las razones aquí, and our conclusion, y nuestra conclusión here. Ese fue el trabajo que hicimos yesterday, right? Este mismo trabajito is gonna help us, nos puede ayudar con nuestro unit product, ¿ok? Let me show you how. We're gonna put it together, alright? Vamos a poner nuestra information together and we are going to change it, we're gonna change it, vamos a cambiarlo a little bit. Okie dokie. So, please pay attention. Number one, your final opinion will be my opinion about distance classes, okay? Este será your final opinion. My opinion about distance classes. ¿Y a qué suena distance classes? Well, sounds like in Spanish, right? Suena como en Spanish, distancia. Clases a distancia. My opinion about distance classes. Alright, so you can use your ideas from session 5, okay? For example, if you write, it's good that the schools are closed because we can get infected. Si escribiste una idea o algo que te gustó mucho, como algo bueno, como it's good that the schools are closed. Because we can get infected, alright? Puedes utilizarlo. Recuerda que schools being closed, que las escuelas están cerradas, y classes and distant classes are related, están relacionadas, ¿ok? Entonces, tú muy bien, puedes utilizar ideas que ya escribiste para ese, sobre tu opinión de las escuelas cerradas, y utilizarlos en esta opinión, que es sobre distant classes, ¿ok? También, if you write, it's sad because I miss my friends, también si escribiste algo malo sobre schools being closed, también puedes utilizarlo en tu próxima opinión, que es sobre distance classes, alright? So, let's gonna put it together, let's gonna put it together, ponemos juntos, I'm gonna show you how. Okay, so the title is My Opinion About Distance Classes. Okay, so you can start, podemos comenzar con una expression to give opinion. Yo voy a comenzar con I think that, pero recuerda que yo te dejé una lista de otras expressions que podemos utilizar como in my opinion, I feel that, I believe, In my point of view, so there are several ways to give your opinion, ¿ok? Tienes muchas formas de decir tu opinión. Ok, so start with something good. Comienza con algo good, something that you like about distance classes. Comienza con algo that you like sobre distance classes. For example, I think that distance classes are good because, y aquí me dices why, porque piensas que son good. Because I can stay with my family, because I am safe, because I can wear my pajamas all day. So, comenzamos con algo good, alright, something that you like. Then, I also think that, y en esta parte escribimos algo que no nos guste tanto, that we don't like very much, something bad. For example, I also think that it is difficult to learn, alright? En esta parte escribirás algo que tal vez no está tan good, it's not that good, alright? Something bad, something that you don't like. For example, I also think that it is difficult to learn. I also think that it is difficult to do many homeworks. I also think that I don't like, I don't know, alright? Recuerda que son tus opinions. Then, something to improve. Después de que me dijiste algo good, algo bad, ahora algo to do it better. Okay? For example, in my opinion, distance classes can be better if... ¿Tú qué opinas? ¿Tú qué dices? ¿Cómo podríamos mejorar distance classes? For example, in my opinion, distance classes can be better if... ¿Podrían mejorar? ¿Sí? Can be better if... all the teachers make videos, alright? Or distance classes can be better if we don't have many homeworks, okay? Recuerda que es your opinion, okay? Okay, chicos, en este punto, tu opinión sobre distance classes no es solo sobre tus English classes, sino sobre tus Spanish classes, sobre tus math classes, sobre tu physical education classes, alright? Sobre todas tus clases en general, alright? And to finish, you can say, in conclusion, to finish, alright? En esta parte, terminas tu opinión y es lo último que dirás, ¿sí? In conclusion, I miss my school and normal classes and... is for my own health. Y es para mi salud. So, here, you're going to finish your opinion, okay? So, one more time. The first part is something good. Something good about distance classes. Something good. In the second one is something bad. Something that you don't like about distance classes. In the third one is something that you need to improve, something that you will do to improve. Algo que harías para improve, mejorar. Y te dejo esta frase. Distance classes can be better if, podrían mejorar, can be better if. And last one, my conclusion or your final opinion, okay? To finish, alright? Para cerrar tu opinion. In conclusion, I like distance classes. In conclusion, I don't like distance classes at all, alright? Recuerda that an opinion is not correct or incorrect, okay? Una opinión is not correct or incorrect, it's just your opinion, ¿ok? Pero una opinión sí puede ser ruda, así que tienes que... ser cortés. So, that's it, okay? This work is going to be your draft. ¿Recuerdas qué es draft? Draft es un borrador. Este trabajo que me mandes será el borrador. It will be the draft of your unit product, okay? On Monday, I will add the last activity of the year, all right? That is going to be the reading of your opinion, okay? Como producto final del mes, tú leerás esta opinión. Pero primero, por eso, tienes que mandar un draft para que tu teacher can help you if you need to make any corrections. Para que te ayude si tienes que hacer alguna correction. Okie dokie. And that's it, guys. I'll see you later.